Oh! Oh! Oh,
oh my God! Are we in safe place?
I hope so.
Yo he demandado a la empresa RWE por los daños medioambientales que ha ocasionado.
They have produced 0.5% of the problem, and they should pay 0.5% of the solution here.
I am very worried about the city of Huaraz if I see how many people live in the evacuation areas.
Mi nombre es Saúl Luciano Lliuya. Bueno, soy de familia de agricultores, de pequeños agricultores, y de profesión soy guía de montaña. Lo principal que me motivó a hacer la demanda es la desglaciación.
In this case, Saúl Luciano Lliuya is demanding that the company RWE take responsibility for its emissions and contribute to measures to reduce the risk of glacial flooding here in Huaraz in the Peruvian mountains.
Here in the back, 23 kilometers behind us, is the lagoon Palcacocha. There is a high risk that big ice glaciers would collapse into the lake, or even parts of the big stones together with it, that then a big wave of water and stones would come, and 50,000 people in this town would be highly at risk.
Cuando hago la demanda, lo hago por esta casa. En el año 1941, cuando pasó el aluvión, pasó por esta zona. Y que según los especialistas, de que si hay un posible también de aluvión, pasaría por esta zona, se va a inundar.
En el caso de la demanda de Saúl Lluvia, podemos ver que su casa está ubicada en Nueva Florida. Y Nueva Florida es un callejón sin salida porque no hay punto de seguridad cercanos, por lo que tiene que cruzar el río y es más peligroso.
And what we're asking RWE to do is only to pay partial amount of the costs that are needed to actually remedy the risk up there at Lake Palcacocha. RWE is a German energy utility who still uses large amounts of coal and has been for many, many years. RWE is the largest single point emitter in Europe still, and it is on the list of the most polluting companies worldwide with respect to greenhouse gases, the carbon majors list.
They have produced 0.5% of the problem, 0.5% of the global emissions since Industrial Revolution, and they should pay 0.5% of the solution here.
This case has already made history. It was declared legally admissible in 2017, so it's the first case of its kind to have gotten this far. As a first step, the court is looking at the issue of flood risk to see whether there's a risk of flooding to the plaintiff's property that's high enough to merit a legal claim. And for that, the court appointed a panel of experts. Those experts, along with two German judges, traveled all the way to the Peruvian Andes.
Aquí al frente, bueno, las rocas que se ven como pulidos son porque ahí ha estado glaciar. Cuando voy a otras montañas es igual que está sucediendo. Las montañas los ves cada año, al año siguiente, rocas cada vez que está descubriéndose. Se sabe que en muchas partes ha habido aluviones. Pues y si la laguna está bastante grande, eso preocupa.
So when you stand next to the Laguna Palcacocha and the glaciers that you can see are retreating, you do not feel safe. And I don't think anyone that has actually visited the site will feel safe.
No me imaginé a principio que iba a llamar mucho la atención. No sé si soy defensor de los glaciares, pero personalmente lo que quiero, ¿no?, es que no siga la desglaciación. También que ya no haya más riesgos. Si se para la desglaciación, solucionas, pues creo, el riesgo de los aluviones.
It's a precedence case to show, on the one hand side, how vulnerable many parts, in this case of Peru and the Andes, are, and on the other side, of the responsibility of the biggest emitters in the world.
So we're not saying RWE is responsible for everything or for the whole of climate change worldwide, only in so far as they have emitted, will they have to pay for the costs of adaptation to climate change. We are now here to gather evidence to actually finish the case also on the factual side. We're not looking to trace a molecule from RWE's installations to the Peruvian Andes. That's not what's happening here, because it is not necessary. Climate change is a cumulative problem. Emissions from one side of the globe affect everyone else on the globe, essentially. And that's the concept of the case, global neighborhood.
This means that in climate change, where emissions produced in Germany have an effect everywhere in the world. So we are all connected as neighbors by those emissions. And the court judge has already agreed to say yes, he accepts this as a basis for the outcome of this legal court case here.
I think such cases are intensely important to actually make clear what happens globally with climate change and how unjust the impacts are actually distributed around the globe. People who are affected by climate change should not stand without rights. And that's what I'm concerned with, that many people think that they stand without rights. And as a lawyer, I want to say, no, you're not without rights.
I think it's important to see that Saul is not fighting for himself, but fighting for a precedence case which empowers entire Peru, but also other countries which are affected from climate change, that they can play a role to change the dynamics in the world in a positive direction. And this is an iconic case in this situation, and Saul is great to move this forward.